Good morning. In the series of online tutorial, we discuss today a important topic, that is connection oriented protocols and connection less protocols. Now, what is connection oriented protocols? In a few lines, we can say that if there is a necessity of both the end at the same time available, then we can then only we can transmit our data, that is connection oriented protocols, connection oriented transmission. Say for example, telecommunication. As and when we want to talk to another person, we have to compulsorily establish a connection between sender as well as user. That is, without making a proper connection and without making live both of the end, we are not able to make the proper conversation. That is a connection oriented. And now, connection less, that means at the both end, sender as well as receiver are required to make a proper transmission, but at the same time, that is not compulsion. If either of the receiver is not available at the same time, then we can also transmit our data. That is connection-less transmission. So as an example for connection-less transmission, we can say that mail, messaging, message servicing, or email. Whenever we are passing mail, there is no requirement to live at that same time of the receiver. So that is a connection less. Now in the protocol, we have file transmission protocol. Like to transmit our data, we have different kinds of protocols. In that, we have two protocols, TCP as well as UDP. TCP, it works as a connection oriented protocol, while UDP, it works like connection less protocol. So we discuss TCP and UDP in detail. Now here, connection oriented protocols. As you can see in the image, to make a proper smooth conversation between device A and device B, we have to make a path before transmitting the data. That is a stream of data, and we can say that there is a dotted line. Dotted line explain the path, logical path between device A and device B. Now device A and device B can make a transmission between the sender and receiver. Connection oriented protocols is networking protocol used to establish a data communication session in which endpoint devices use primary protocols to establish end-to-end connections, and then the subsequent data stream is delivered in the sequential transfer mode. So in the first point, they suggest that before transmitting the data, we have to make a solid fixed connectivity between sender and receiver. COP, that means connection oriented protocol, guarantees sequential data delivery. It makes a guaranteed transmission, sure transmission, but are classed as an unreliable network service because there is no process to ensure that total data is received at the same they want to send. In connection oriented protocols, circuit switch connections or virtual circuit connections in packet switch networks are available. There is a sequence of operations which are the sequence followed by connection oriented protocols. Like here, connection is established. So first operation is establish the connection. Second one, that is send the information, and third one, release the connection, make a connection, transmit your data, and finally release your connection. Now switch over to TCP, transmission control protocol. So it's what suggested transmission, to make a transmission between transmission of data from sender to receiver, then it will control over the transmission. So TCP works like is a standard that defines how to establish and maintain a network conversation through which application program can be exchanged the data. TCP works with the IP Internet Protocol, which defines how computers are sent packets of data to each other. Now here there are some techniques, or we can say steps, how transmission control protocol works, how TCP works. So as we discuss, TCP is a connection oriented protocol. Is it clear? TCP is a connection oriented protocol, which means a connection is established and maintained until the application programs at each end have finished exchanging the messages. So from this we can say that TCP is a connection oriented protocol, and hence we have to establish the connectivity. After making a connection, we can transmit our data, and whenever we are transmitting the data, the connection is required. It determines how to break application data into packets. If we have a large file, if we have multiple data, then TCP determines how to break into small packets of the data that network can deliver. Sends packets to the receiver or to the network, and accept packets from the network. Manage flow control. It also determines how to manage the flow control, on which route they have to transmit the data. Handles retransmission of dropped or gravel packets and acknowledge all packets that arrive. TCP protocol also works to make retransmission. Which kind of retransmission? During the network, if some packets is lost, then drop or gravel packets and acknowledgement all packets are arrived. So that is a retransmission. In the OSI communication model, TCP covers parts of layer 4, that is the transport layer, and the parts of layer 5, that is session layer. So we can also say that TCP works in both of the layer, transport layer as well as session layer. For an example, when a web server sends an HTML file to a client, that is the example of HTML file. How we can execute HTML file? It uses the hypertext transfer protocol HTTP. Okay, that is another example of connection oriented. HTTP program layers ask TCP layer to set up the connection and send the file. Okay, that is the first task. The TCP stack. Stack means multiple applications or protocols. Divides the file into data packets. Whatever we are sending as a HTML file, at TCP stack will divide this HTTP program into number of packets, numbers them, and then forward them individually to the IP layer. The TCP program layer in the client computer waits until all packets are arrived. Say, if we have a file, HTTP file with a 1 GB, and TCP will break a 1 GB file into 10 different segments. To 0.1, 0.1, 0.1 have 10 different packets, and all the packets are moved from sender to destination with different paths. What client waits? Client will wait for all the packets are arrived, then acknowledge those it receives and ask for retransmission if any required. The TCP layer then reassemble the packet into a file and delivers the file to the receiving applications. So that is the task of TCP stack. Now there are some another task of TCP protocol. TCP is used If in exam there is a question asked by examiner, write an application, write an short note on TCP transmission control protocol, then you have to write this connection oriented protocol, what is meant by connection oriented protocols, and TCP is an example of connection oriented protocol, and then you have to explain the example of HTTP 5 along with these features and examples. TCP is used for organizing data in a way that ensures the secure transmission between server and client. It guarantees whatever the transmission is performed. There are some examples of TCP connection oriented protocol: SSH, Secure Shell, FTP file transfer protocol, Telnet, peer-to-peer file transmission, Telnet, SMTP, POP, IMAP, HTTP. These are the examples of connection oriented protocols. Now, features of TCP. That is a reliable protocol. Why reliable? Because it makes the connection and holds the connectivity until the transmission is completed. So whenever user wants to transmit their data over the network, then that is reliable. Ensure that the data is reaches, connection oriented, provides error checking and recovery mechanism. TCP also deals with the errors. Errors related to transmission during the network. So it make the error checking as well as error recovery mechanism. End-to-end communication, that means sender to receiver communication, flow control, quality of service, client service, duplex server, full duplex server. It can perform role of both receivers as well as sender. Now there is an important segment of TCP, that is a header. So you can say that here 0 to 7, 0 to 7, again 0 to 7 and 0 to 7. That means we have 8 bits multiplied by 4, that is 24 bit of TCP header. So there are we have to remember this. This is the questions related to your exam. Now here options. If you want to pass some additional parameters, and if you want to make your task customized, then we can pass the options. It is a 28 bit. Now there is a two segment of upper layer, that is checksum as well as urgent. If you want to make a prioritize your transmission, then you can set urgent over here, and checksum errors occur during the transmission. Window size, whenever you are transmitting your data in packet or frame, then we have to convert your data into window. Flags, acknowledgement, sending data, not sending, properly receiving or not, that is these are the flags. Received data, data offset, acknowledgement number. If properly data is sending on the receiver side, then it will pass the acknowledgement, that is acknowledgement number. Sequence number, which data we are transmitting, and destination port as well as source port. This is the formation architecture of TCP header. We have to learn this, we have to remember this. Now here the description of each of this, so we can say that source port, it defines the source port of the application process on the sending device. So device A is sending, device B is receiving, so we can say that source port of 16 bit here, source port 2 byte 16 bit. It defines which port we are using, destination port, again that is a 16 bit, on which port we can transmit our transmission or transmit our data as a at a receiver side, there is a port of sender as well as receiver. Sequence number, that is a second sequence number. It defines sequence number of data bytes of a segment in a session. third one, next one, third, that is acknowledgement number, SCK bit, SCK flag is set. This number contains the next sequence number of the data byte expected and works as the acknowledgement of the previous data received. So whatever we are transmitting to the sender, that is a byte of data, and another one, that is a acknowledgement of previous data sent. Next one, that is data offset. The field implies both the size of TCP header and the offset of data is current package in a whole TCP segment. Next one, received. Reserved for future use and all are set 0 by default. Flags, there are so many flags and each flags have value of 1 bit each. TCP flags are used within TCP packet transferred to indicate a particular connection state or provides additional information. Window size. The field is used for flow control between two stations and indicates the amount of buffer. Checksum. This field contains the checksum of header, data and pseudo headers. Urgent pointer to point to the urgent data byte if URG flag is set to 1. Options. Additional options which are not covered by the regular header. There are so many flags available in TCP header. These are the CWR, ECE, URG, ACK, PSH, RST, SYN, FIN and NS. So these are the flags. We can use this flag with the TCP header. Now, there are some ports available with TCP protocol. First of all, what is the use of port? So, there is a small mechanism. Whenever we are using data transmission, then we are passing our data from one source, one local system to another system. So, to enter to the another system, we have to make a dedicated path or dedicated connections. So using this port number, we can make the proper connectivity between two systems. So TCP ports numbers, here we have some common ports number. A port number is a 16-bit unsigned integer that's ranging from 0 to 65535. TCP port number is 0 is reserved and cannot be used, while for UDP the source port is optional and the value 0 means no port. A process associated its input or output channel via internet socket, which is a type of file descriptor with a transport protocol and IP protocol, and it have a port number. So this is also known as binding. This is also known as binding and enables the process to send and receive data via the network. So that is a process of port binding. We can also set it port binding. Once you are making a port usable with a particular application, then this port only works for this particular application. Right? This is a that is a port binding. The operating system's networking software has a task of transmitting outgoing data from all application ports onto the network and forwarding arrive network packets to process by matching the packet's IP address and port number. TCP, only one process may bind to a specific IP address. There are some well-known ports. These are the 0 to 1023 number. Registered port are 1024 to 49151. These are not assigned and controlled, but can be registered to prevent the duplications.
Dynamic ports are 49,152 to 65535. There are list of some common protocols. Port number 20, that is used by FTP data transfer. 21, used by FTP to make control. 22, SSH login. 23, used by telnet. 25, used by SMTP. 53, used by DNS, and so on. These are the list of common port numbers. Now, how they are managing the connectivity between transmission? So we can say that to make the connectivity, there is an initiator and as well as responder, that is the established of connectivity. Client initiate the connection and sends the segment with the sequence number. So this is a client. Server acknowledge it back with its own sequence number and acknowledgement. And client, after receiving the acknowledgement of the segment, sends an acknowledgement of server's response. Whenever the transmission is complete, the connection is lost. That is a connection management. Now another one, and that is connectionless protocol. Up to this, we discussed our four connection-oriented protocols, and now connectionless protocol. In this connectionless protocol, it describes the communication between two network endpoints where a message is sent from one end point to another without a prior arrangement. There is no requirement to make a proper or fixed communication link. Each data packet has a destination address. Here, whenever we are transmitting the data, it converts into packet, and each packet have the destination address. And now, the data packets may follow different paths to reach the destination, right? And this data, this packets, is called as datagrams. Some protocols allow for error correction by requesting a retransmission if necessary. There are some examples and services. IP, UDP, ICMP are the connectionless protocol. Now UDP, User Datagram Protocol. There is some limitations, or we can say there is a difference between TCP and UDP. That is, TCP is reliable, but UDP is unreliable and connectionless protocol. For the real-time service like computer gaming, voice or video communication, live conferencing, we need UDP. UDP permits packets to be dropped instead of processing delayed packets. Okay, whenever we are transmitting the data and receiver is not ready, then in TCP will wait while the receiver is not ready. But in the case of UDP, it will not wait. It has no error checking mechanism in UDP, so we have to make another logic or another application to make the error checking and correction. And we deploy UDP where the acknowledgement packets share significant amount of bandwidth along with the actual data. There are some features of UDP. Acknowledgement of the data does not hold any significance, because if you not provide acknowledgement for proper communication, that is a unidirectional protocol. UDP is good protocol for data flowing in one direction. UDP is simple and suitable for query based communication. Like whenever we are requesting you to make some assignments or to make some answers from your side, but that is whenever we are asking to you, you are only allowed to make the answers. That is a query based communication. UDP does not guarantee order delivery, and that is a stateless protocol. There is a UDP header. It is a 32-bit of header, source port, destination port, as we discussed in TCP. Another one, that is length and checksum. Length field specifies the entire length of UDP packet. There are some applications of UDP. UDP is also worked in routing information protocol RIP, and there are some implementation, network time protocol, domain name service, network news protocol, TFTP. These are the protocols where we can use UDP. We can also use the UDP in the trace the route, record the route, timestamp, like. Now, to summarize the today's session, we can say that there are some differences between connection oriented as well as connection less services or protocols. Here we mention some characteristics of protocol and the description of the service. So first of all, definition: connection oriented and connection less. There is a virtual connection is created before sending the packet over the internet. Without creating any virtual connection over the internet, it will transmit the data. Authentication: while we are using connection oriented protocol, it must be authenticated. It must be authenticated. While without authentication, we can pass in connection less. Connection oriented, that is more reliable, but connection less is not reliable compared to connection oriented. Handshaking is carried out. What is handshaking? So before this is a handshaking. First one, hello. That is a handshaking between the two systems. So handshaking is carried out in connection oriented, while no handshaking is carried out in connection less services. Connection oriented is slower. Why? Because first they have to create the connection, sure about the connectivity, hold the session of live connectivity, and then they transmit the data. So little bit connection oriented is slower compared to connection less protocol. Connection less is somewhat faster. Connection less connection oriented system requires more parameters in the header, while it has a small header size. Route is finalized and decided in connection oriented because it has a physical connectivity link between sender and receiver. While here connection less service, no route is decided. Connection oriented, it follows the same path for all the transmission. While connection less protocol, connection less service, there is no necessity. There is no necessary to make a same sequence, same route. As an example, TCP is connection oriented protocol and UDP is connection less protocol. Thank you so much.